getting there, there now. Boys. Two to go.
Wow, made a big gain right there. That's huge. He might have found something when he got fourth to that high side there a while ago.
He did find something. He was 0.4 seconds faster than Jimmy Johnson that last lap.
And you can see Jimmy Johnson take that away from him right there. Wow.
He's got a fight on his hands here this last week, too.
White flag.
Get yourself on. Let's go get it now.
That was big right there. Jimmy Johnson took that away. Carl Edwards was going to get to the outside of him and have a chance to make the pass.
Still might get him right here.
Here he comes, digging up off the corner. Turn two, half a lap away from the checkered flag.
And what's Jimmy Johnson do here? He goes to that high side. Carl Edwards is going to go to the bottom. There we go.
Try job.
Trying to take the lead away.
Try job.
The momentum. The 18. They make contact. The 18 in the wall.
We're back inside now.
Oh, wow.
Carl Edwards trying to hang on. Here comes Jimmy Johnson down, and Johnson will take the win. Wow.
How good is that? Wow.
Baby. Awesome work. Awesome work, Mr.
It's over, right? It's over.
That's it. Checkered flag's out.
When Darrell Waltrip won the first sprint all-star race.
We won this thing. You guys are unbelievable. Woo!
Darrell won $200,000.
You got to get behind the show car there.
Carl has banked that much tonight in bonus money. He's going to take home $1,203,000.
You know what I like most about that 10-lap segment, Darrell? Carl had it loaded up.
He was here he comes.
Nice even start. 21, take off maybe a slight second before the 24. I think he's going to clear.
Three wide, the restart under review.
Oh, look at this, 21. Look at this.
Here goes three wide up the middle. What a move. Look at Danny, but it isn't over.
No. And Blaney jumped the restart. That is NASCAR's ruling. And it's true.
Twenty laps are complete.
They're going to wave the caution.
I believe.
However, it will be decided. The finishing order is decided at the start finish line at the end of segment 20. And at the line, Trevor Bayne, who restarted fourth by 0.05 of a second, beat Chase Elliott to the line. And Trevor Bayne's showdown is done. He moves on to the All-Star race.
I like this. This is cute. I want this inside of me. Oh, yeah. That's good. Kind of got a funny aftertaste, though.
Clean here, clean here. Just slight contact.
Oh,
look at that thing go.
That looks so much like Edwards' turnover at Talladega off the bumper of Keselowski. On the way to break, we saw that hat on the track. The hat on the track did not belong to the cat in the hat. Page Dr. Seuss, please.
Yes, I see the hat. I'm glad I see the cat because I was a little worried.
Hey, here's a fellow who thinks that is Jack Roush's hat.
My hat!
Oof. Dale Jr.
Now, we know that Jack Roush changes crew chiefs like I changed my socks, but I hope he keeps all of those guys together there for a while. Listen to what Jack had to say about old Finney.
Jimmy is he's a consummate stock car racer. You know, he can run your R&D team. He can take your rookie driver. Heck, he even won a championship with Kurt Busch. He can do anything. And that was the biggest job I've ever seen done.
Nobody does it better.
Oh, it was some wild events. Like on lap 119, Matt Kenseth has got tire problems. So he heads down pit road. Uh-oh. Matt's in trouble. He wanted to go for repairs, and that was...
No!
Headed right into the barrier. The race was delayed for 12 minutes.
Bill, spotter tells the crew, coming to you just as fast as you can blink your eye.
Oh, and a
Oh my God! There she goes.
That's going to be a caution. That's actually good luck for him.
Long way to go, though, to get to his pit stall, the number one stall, all the way at the end of pit road.
And you know what? The tire's still going to be right there.
Shepherd in the middle of this mix. He's run up there all day long.
A year ago, Morgan Shepherd led this race. He has led it today. He finished 13th. He said it was that win.
Oh, oh. Out of control goes Kenseth.
And oh! Over on his roof. Ooh.
Get back.
Ooh. Ooh.
What the f***?
Let's see how he gets on the road here, how fast he comes off the track.
3, 2, 1, now.
Pretty good pace coming out of pit road and in the middle, hard on the brakes, 146 miles an hour at the end.
Nice and clean into the box. Going to do the left sides first.
So that's both Roush Fenway Fords going to the left side first. Ricky Stenhouse, his teammate, was 16.3.
Hard.
16.1 for Matt Kenseth's team.
Nice stop.
Oh, he got on the apron.
Yeah, it was a nice stop. It wasn't the best speed of getting on the pit road, though, Jeff. I think he was a little off there, it looked like.
That will be the best pit stop of the day if there are no penalties. Two all-star polls for Matt, 2002 and 2007. And yes, they have reason to celebrate.
Celebrate, boys, celebrate. Finally, something good happened to us.
If any team needs a little boost, it's that one.
I'm telling you, that's pretty impressive.
I failed. My career is over.
Greg Biffle, he drives that number 16, Red Cross. Chevrolet.
Oh, no.
Repeat.
The top here in 1 and 2.
That's absolutely right.
One more time around in stage one. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. out front.
Let's see what he does. Is he going to stay on the top or go to the bottom?
Kurt Busch dives down low. He's got to run, see where it goes. Got a big gap between him and the next car. Probably going to fizzle out on the back straightaway. Let's see if Dillon creates a run and maybe turns left, like you said, Jeff, and tries to take that lead.
It's Kyle Busch.
He gets a little bit of quarter panel on the 42 side draft, and he's going to get help. Comes William Byron to the inside. He's got a great run up to Austin Dillon. He goes high.
Here comes the 18 of Kyle Busch, trying to make that high line work. Austin Dillon trying to block. It's not going to work this time, though. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. in the 17 out front. Three wide as they fight for second at the end of stage one. Stenhouse Jr. winning that stage. Kyle Busch, what a move he made to move up to second.
Down and they get to you. He's not. He's going to jump down, so stay with him right now.
Steve Barkdahl, the spotter there for Michael McDowell. Heard him say, you know how he is. He'll jump down there and block if they go down. So he wants to figure out, do you stay with the 17 or do you try to make a pass?
He's going to stay right there where he's at. He's going to try to get to the end of this race, have a shot to win.
Final lap of stage two, and now they're trying to go two wide. Ty Dillon in the 13 thinks otherwise. He gets back in line. Trevor Bain still trying something in the six.
Let's go, guys. Move around. Make something happen.
Will anyone try to get by Ricky Stenhouse Jr. as they work their way through 3 and 4, coming to the green-white checkered flag to end stage two, and it looks as though it's going to be Ricky Stenhouse Jr. sweeping the first two stages. Before tonight, Roush Fenway has never won a stage, and now already two.
Eventually.
Too early, then you drag everybody back to you. You drag that back on caution. There it is.
Ricky Stenhouse Jr. around. The tire pressure. That's what you did.
Down in the grass, you're fine. Nothing else coming.
Paul Menard races down pit road because...
Well, this sucks.
Against those people down there, maybe.
Well, there's a ditch and then, of course, the other guardrail there.
Now, this ought to be a real shot.
Ooh.
Pit
actually thought the 6 of Matt Kenseth, who lets Ricky Stenhouse go, that'll put Stenhouse back on the lead lap. I thought the 6 would come to pit road as well. Perhaps Adam Stevens did as well. But it was, I mean, it was a blink of an eye. From up here, I couldn't tell. I have a good vision to start, finish, and pit in, and I couldn't tell who got where first. But you see it at the top of your screen. NASCAR knows. They said the 18 hit the commitment line after Matt Kenseth hit the start-finish line. That closed pit road before the end of the stage.
And Matt Kenseth, now with almost a four-second lead over Chase Elliott, is going to get the stage win. Matt Kenseth coming in for Roush Fenway Racing to try to improve the overall competition, and I would say that this is a big improvement because Matt Kenseth will win stage two at Indy.
Wow.
We did. You know, practice, my qualifying run felt really, really good in our fifth, third, fourth. Just I went out the first round and we were really loose, so we had to make a second run there in first round, which I felt like may have hurt us a little bit. I'd have liked to have ran that one and then gone out early in the second round so that if we needed to run two in the second round, we could. But I was glad of the pickup. We ran a 29-20 to start qualifying. We ran an 85 there at the end, so a good qualifying result. You know, we got to make it a little bit better in race trim, though.
You and I talked earlier today, and you said, with the Kyle Busch comments, you said, I really don't care what Kyle thinks. We saw you after you got out of your car. You went over to chat with him. A change of heart, perhaps, or did you feel like you needed to say something?
Not really a change of heart. I just told him why I didn't reach out. I felt like he ran his mouth enough on his radio, and then after the race that I didn't really have anything to say to him, and you know, I honestly feel like, you know, that I'd normally do reach out to people when I make mistakes, and I clearly made a mistake, but you know, with him running his mouth, I just felt like I don't really need to call him. So I just let him know that. I told him that, you know, I was like, hey, you're right, you do run a lot further up front, but I was like, pick and choose your battles wisely, because, you know, you will have to deal with me sometime, whether you're lapping me or we get our cars better and we're up there racing with you. So I told him, if you want to keep running his mouth, he'd come over and do it around me, and I'll stop it for me, for myself. So
from your end, is it over?
Yeah, I mean, I'm fine. But if he wants to keep running his mouth, he can come over and do it to me.
There you go. Some obviously strong words from Ricky Stenhouse after Kyle Busch's strong words earlier today, Dale.
Basically, stay on the bottom. 18, they're not organized on the outside. They're getting organized. Get up there. Too late. I'm afraid to say it, but I think Stenhouse was involved in this one as well.
I do too.
Can't wait to see the replay so we can really dissect how this all started.
Back down, they block the six.
Here it is. There it is. Ryan drives into the right rear quarter panel. Ty was right.
Thank you. Sunday. Could you come to Atlanta and hang out with us? I think we love you.
All four Hendrick cars having problems today. It's opened the door for a Ford. Greg Biffle gets the white flag. One more lap to his first win of the year. Think about Jimmy Johnson led laps, had a dominant car. The same for Casey Kane. In fact, both he and Dale Earnhardt Jr. had issues while leading. The cat in the hat feeling good. 12 times he has won here at Michigan.
You know, that was a big relief when he heard that over the radio. It's like, okay, I could breathe now. I got three laps, I could breathe.
A runner-up last week at Pocono. No doubt, Greg Biffle's team going in the right direction. How about his fourth win?
Been running right up against the wall. Oh, and the 33 is into the wall. Austin Dillon gets into the wall after running right up against it. He gets into the wall. The 42 is going to go by for the lead. Larson looking for his third career win.
Bringing on home. We waited all year, baby.
Larson will win in Miami. And Chris Buescher, final time through 3 and 4. Chris Buescher will win the title of the Xfinity Series.
We are the
my friends.
Use your head.
But I don't want to use my head! Oh! Ow!
That hurts so bad.
Negotiate two more corners, and he's going to do it again at Iowa Speedway.
He dominated last week, Marty. Didn't get the win, but it looks as though he's got a little redemption.
What the hell?
Oh, look out!
No!
Right into it! They crossed the line, and guess who wins the race? Stenhouse!
Well, thanks to Carl Edwards. Gave them
unreal crazy finish. Sadler comes across the line third. Wise fourth. Almirola fifth. And Reed Sorensen wins the 100 grand in the dash for cash.
Oh, man, this is a bad piece. Holy what a pile of
comes our way.